Getting ready to buy or sell a home in 30, 60, or 90 days? Check out BundleSelect.com to find out how you could save 20% or more on your entire transaction, real estate, lending, and title. With BundleSelect.com, technology and a personal concierge are at your service to save you time and money. The real estate world is changing, and it's finally in your favor. BundleSelect's hand-picked team of experts will compete for your business, so you'll save thousands of dollars by bundling services. BundleSelect.com gives you all the control, including using your own realtor. I'm Joe Cachera with Real Estate Radio Live, and I have been on the radio educating consumers for years. I'm here to tell you BundleSelect.com is the newest way to save money on real estate. By bundling services like real estate, lending, and title, you could save tens of thousands of dollars. We'll even take care of your move for free anywhere in the Bay Area. Visit BundleSelect.com. That's BundleSelect.com.
The 20% savings estimates are based on industry averages, and the free move is provided that the minimum amount of vendor savings covers the cost of the move. Real Estate Broker, Calbieri, 00466-902.
Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging podcast discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cachera, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cachera.
Welcome in, Joe Cachera with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you again for following the show today. Those on Facebook, continue to follow the show. Give us your feedback and your thoughts. We really appreciate all the comments that you make. Also, be sure to download the podcast. We realize that's the best way to listen and view the show is to download the podcast. You could do that. You could do that by going to reradiolive.com, or you could also go to iTunes and just type in Real Estate Radio Live. When you do that, that'll come up, and you can download the podcast a few different ways to get that. The show is focused, for those who have been following us, thank you, first of all, but the show is focused on education and information. When I started the show over 7 years ago, the goal, the objective was to provide the consumers with information and education so that they make wise choices in and around their real estate. So what we do at Real Estate Radio Live is we work really hard to get good guests on the show like I have today, and I'll introduce Dave in just a minute. Also to provide you with content, information. Again, when you get to that point where you make a decision whether you're buying, selling, renting, financing, you know, anything you're doing with real estate, the goal is to help you become a more wise consumer, and that's what we'll continue to do. During the week, lastly, if you'd like to reach me, it's 408-838-9060, or you could always email joe@reradiolive.com. All right, let me invite my guest in, David Robertson, who hasn't been on for a while, but we're going to have him on a continued basis because he is an expert in a couple of different areas and very informative, and I think you'll get a lot of good information from David. So I want to welcome you today. Good to have you again.
Thanks, Joe. Thanks for having me back.
Yeah, good to have you back. So David is a principal with Silicon Valley Property Management Group, manages over 150 properties. We'll get into more of that, but David's going to take us through some details on not only, you know, what's going on in the Bay Area, some of the real estate market, the renters versus owners. We're going to get into some of the books he's written and some really good information. By the way, we're going to give those books away, so stay tuned. As we go through the show, we'll give you the information on how to get those. And also some strategies and thought processes around what do you do with all this equity. We'll talk a little bit about that too, because most of us know one of the biggest reasons we do have a housing shortage here is because, quite frankly, a lot of people are sitting on millions and millions of dollars of equity appreciation in their home, and they don't want to be taxed. And so we're going to talk a little bit about some ways to get around that. Before we start, David, maybe if you could give us, just take a minute or so, give us a little bit about your background and then your roles and responsibilities as a principal here, and we'll get started.
Thanks, Joe.
You're welcome.
First and foremost, I'm a real estate attorney. I practiced law in Santa Clara County for 12-plus years at Rossi Hammerslaw. I'm also a licensed real estate broker. Started Silicon Valley Property Management Group approximately 5 years ago. Okay. And as you mentioned, we manage residential, commercial, and retail property here in Silicon Valley for investors, non-owner occupied property owners. Additionally, I own rental properties myself, and I'm also certified in 12 building code categories, which puts me in a unique position to understand components of properties that other property managers might not otherwise understand. one of the key components to my service is I actually offer free legal advice to my clients that own property in the state of California, mm-hmm. which is a service that most other property managers can't offer just because they're not licensed attorneys.
Right. Right.
The confluence of all of my experience allows me to offer a value-added package to my clients. To elaborate on something that you're saying, the marketplace is incredibly expensive, and everybody knows that. We read it in the paper every day.
Right.
And because of that, the rental marketplace is a burgeoning mm-hmm. place where renters exist, and they have to deal with the landlords that are out there. Santa Clara County Tax Assessor Larry Stone just put out a report year-end 2017 that said that 56% of properties in San Jose are owner-occupied properties, which means the remaining aren't. So there's a ton of rental properties that are out in the marketplace. Most of those are actually managed by mom and pop or the owners themselves. And that's where I come into play. I can be very helpful for those people that really don't understand the law, don't understand their obligations
right.
under the law, violate tenants' rights. And that's one of the things that I offer to my clients.
Yeah. No, that's a big advantage for sure. For those out there listening to us or watching us on Facebook, and then, of course, when you download the podcast, you listen to this, one of the things that I want to highlight right now about David is he's an attorney at the same time manages in properties. The reason why that's so important, as he just stated, is that you really get someone that understands this business, understands property, understands the rights back and forth on both sides. And we're going to talk about the successful business, too, because it's one thing to have the knowledge, but you certainly got the background. You've been doing this a long time.
Yes.
And over 150 properties. Tell us a little bit about, if you can, David, just maybe kind of an overview of the market, how you see it, maybe some of your takes on why we have the shortage here in real estate, and then we could talk a little bit more about kind of the rental side of it and get some education on that side.
Right. So because of Silicon Valley's success with all the tech companies, it obviously has created a huge housing shortage across the Bay Area on both sides of the Bay, in North Bay and South Bay. And that's nobody's fault but the marketplace. I mean, it's a marketplace like any other marketplace.
Right.
And because of that, coupled with more recently the tax reform that was just passed by our government, it's estimated that a first-time home buyer buying a $1.2 million house will have $25,000 less in exemptions that they'll be able to write off. So it made buying a home just that much more difficult, which increases the pressure on the rental marketplace because
right.
those people that can't buy are still out in that marketplace and they're still looking for those properties that come on and disappear quite mm-hmm. frequently. Additionally, one of the key components that you mentioned in your opening that's causing the inventory shortage is the capital gains issue.
Right.
In California, which is the highest capital gains rate in the United States, mm-hmm. it's approximately 38% tax on capital gains, you know, for people that sell their homes. So, for example, if someone's lived in the Bay Area, on the peninsula in particular, for 30, 40 years, they may have 1.5, 2 million, 2.5, 3 million of unprotected capital gain.
Mm-hmm.
So, after your purchase price and any improvements, which calculate to your basis, a person selling their home would get, a married couple would get $500,000. Tax-free, or a single individual will get $250,000.
Right.
But anything above that would be taxed at that 38% rate. So if somebody had, for example, a $2 million unprotected gain, mm-hmm. that's a $760,000 tax hit the next April.
Boy.
That in and of itself is enough that is keeping most of these people on the sidelines.
Right.
And they're choosing, which is not a bad strategy, they're choosing to rent their property out,
mm-hmm.
or they're choosing to hold on to their property and delay that tax hit
right.
until either one of the spouses dies or some other event happens or both spouses die. And so then there would be a stepped-up basis, and then they wouldn't have to worry about the capital gains.
Right.
Before we met, we talked about a strategy that we have mm-hmm. that I actually talk about in my book.
Right.
I call it the golden strategy,
mm-hmm.
where someone could use IRC Section 121 plus IRC 1031 and basically take your personal exemption and then exchange your property after renting it out for a couple of years and you would completely eliminate the capital gains exposure or defer the capital gains
right.
exposure, allowing yourself to reap the benefits of that property
yeah.
and putting it into another property and then maybe devising that property to your grandkids and completely eliminating that capital gains exposure during your lifetime. I think it's a great strategy. My wife and I have several clients that are currently utilizing that. It's something that everybody should at least consider
mm-hmm.
that have this problem. Now, whether or not the government does something to get rid of that capital gains issue is something that we're going to see down the road. But personally, I think you and I agree that it's probably the main driving factor that's causing inventory to be so bad.
Yeah, I agree 100%. And before as we're talking about this, so I'm going to show it here for the benefit of those on Facebook. So David has a couple of books that he's written. Well, this is the one he was referring to right now about some of the investment strategies, Your Guide to Real Estate Investing. It's a real simple read, easy to understand. And so my understanding is that anybody either viewing us on Facebook or when they download this podcast, they'll be able to get one of these free by contacting you, right?
Yeah, send me an email.
What is the best way? So we'll get into also, because David has a book also on how to legally rent out your house, which it sounds easy, but it's not, and we're going to get into that later. But in the meantime, we'll do this a few times. If someone wants to get a book or find out more information, where would they reach you?
You can reach me either cell phone at 408-838-5113.
Okay.
Or my email, david@svpmg.net.
Very good. So, again, the books, David's been kind enough to give those away to our listeners for free. If you're on Facebook, contact us. You could email. If you're on the road or something later on listening to the podcast, always remember, with any of our guests, you could just go to our website, and they'll be on there. You could kind of figure out who it was and email me, and I could put you in contact with David. But we want to be able to get these books in your hands. You'd really be a valuable resource. And this just gives – one of the things I like about this, David, and I want to talk just another minute or so about it, is that, I think – and I don't know the research on, but I'm guessing that enough people that I talk to is that they're just – a lot of these homeowners don't know about this, is my point that you just talked about. I mean, I think sometimes we think people know everything about everything, right? But,
that's true.
You know, if you've owned a home for 40 years, you're kind of old school, let's face it. You're not with the millennials and all this other stuff. I mean, it's all fun to talk about technology and all this, but let's face it, a lot of these people that own these homes are older. You know, 60s, 70s, 80s plus. And so they may not necessarily know some of the stuff that you're talking about here.
Absolutely.
Right?
And unfortunately, someone that doesn't know and they get involved with maybe a real estate professional that's not helpful.
That's a good
and that's
point.
Only concerned about
right.
selling a house and not giving them sound advice. The question that the real estate agent should ask the person is, have you spoke with your CPA before you make this
mm-hmm.
transaction, because that's the single most important question that everybody is fully informed 100% about all the possibility ways to kind of
yeah.
get around the exposure that they're about to undertake.
Yeah. You know, I had a couple that kind of rings to what you were talking about, piggybacks, in that they were in the same dilemma. They had a house in Las Gatas. It was probably worth close to $4 million. They had owed very little on it. They're retired, and they thought, you know, they were talking with their financial planner, they were talking to me about a possible reverse mortgage, and they didn't really like the idea of that. So, you know, they started asking some questions, and work finds out or comes to terms that, you know, hey, we've always wanted to live by the beach. So what they did was they just rented their place out, and I can't even imagine the number they got. I think they got $8,000 or $9,000 a month for rent, and they had almost no mortgage on it. So then they just went and rented themselves a condo by the beach, I think in either Capitola or Aptos or something like that, for a year or so until they decide what they want to do with the place and then they convert to it. And then kind of your strategy, and they're going to do what your strategy you just talked about.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a cool idea when you think about it, right?
Yeah, it is. It's an excellent strategy. A lot of people become old and they can't take care of their property.
Yeah.
Maybe the property has a bunch of stairs. This is several levels. And they want something simpler, like maybe a condo in a high rise, or a condo on the golf course or on the beach. That's much easier to navigate and take care of.
Right.
So the strategy is they move out of their house mm-hmm. and they rent it for a year and a day or longer, up to 2 years, because 121 requires you to live in your primary residence mm-hmm. two out of the last 5 years.
Okay.
And if you sell it within that time frame, then you still get the benefit of the 121 $500,000 exemption for a married couple, you could put that money right in your pocket, tax-free.
Right.
And then you exchange through 1031 the balance, either for that amount of money, or you can actually leverage that money up and find buy something a little bit bigger.
Okay.
But finding a better cap rate, a better return on that money somewhere else in the United States. You can do it in any of the 50 states. You can do it in Charlotte, North Carolina. You can do it in Austin, Texas, Indianapolis, Indiana. But finding a better investment, instead of a rental real residential property, find a commercial property, mixed-use property, something that has a better cap rate. I have a friend that all he invests in is bank buildings. He loves to rent to banks.
Yeah.
It's a solid investment.
Right.
So it's something that people don't really think about, but it's something like another arrow in your quiver that you should actually consider doing. And there's, you know, any quality real estate professional understands this strategy, and they can put you in the right hands if it's something that you want to do.
Yeah, good point.
And a lot of different opportunities all across the country happening every single day.
Yeah. Before we switch gears a little bit, David, you'd mentioned is it 121, Rule 121. Is that in terms of – did that change? Is it you still have to be in the house 2 years of the 5 years? Or did that in the last tax law, did anything change in that perspective, or did that stay the same?
Nothing changed.
Okay.
There was a proposal to actually change to, I think, three out of the last seven or
right.
four
something
out of the last
like
seven.
That, yeah.
But nothing changed.
Okay.
Still two out of the last five. And that's that can be on either end. In other words, you can move out for 10 years and you can move back in for two.
Okay.
So there's a number of different ways to skin that cat.
Okay. All right, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take a quick break, and I'm going to come back. We're going to continue the conversation with David Robertson. Next segment, actually, we're going to talk more about how to rent. If you're getting ready to rent your house, what to know about it, who to deal with. We're going to talk about the percentage of people who are kind of the mom-and-pop renters, and we're going to educate in some of those areas. This is Joe Cachera with Real Estate Radio Live. Stay with us on Facebook, and we're back with you in about a minute.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com.
Getting ready to buy or sell a home in 30, 60, or 90 days? Check out BundleSelect.com to find out how you could save 20% or more on your entire transaction, real estate, lending, and title. With BundleSelect.com, technology and a personal concierge are at your service to save you time and money. The real estate world is changing, and it's finally in your favor. BundleSelect's hand-picked team of experts will compete for your business, so you'll save thousands of dollars by bundling services. BundleSelect.com gives you all the control, including using your own realtor. I'm Joe Cachera with Real Estate Radio Live, and I have been on the radio educating consumers for years. I'm here to tell you BundleSelect.com is the newest way to save money on real estate. By bundling services like real estate, lending, and title, you could save tens of thousands of dollars. We'll even take care of your move for free anywhere in the Bay Area. Visit BundleSelect.com. That's BundleSelect.com.
The 20% savings estimates are based on industry averages, and the free move is provided that the minimum amount of vendor savings covers the cost of the move. Real Estate Broker, Calbieri, 00466902.
Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's topic or guests, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for today's edition of Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cachera.
Welcome back in. Joe Cachera with Real Estate Radio Live. I'm sitting here today in studio with David Robertson, kind enough to join us with Silicon Valley Property. He is the principal, and the first segment we talked a little bit about one of the books, well, many things. One of the books he came up with is Real Estate, Your Guide to Real Estate Investing, and now we're going to talk a little bit about the next book is How to Legally Rent Out Your Home. That may sound easier than it does by those words coming off my lips, but believe me, there's a lot to it, and we're going to talk about that too. But before we jump back into with David here, again, David is kind enough to give these books away. If you're on Facebook, you're seeing them. If you're not, if you're listening to the podcast, if you'd like to email the site one way or another, I'll get it to you, but I'll have David one more time. Why don't you give your website and phone number for those that want a book?
Yeah, sure. It's www.SiliconValleyPropertyManagementGroup.com, or the shorthand is www.svpmg.net.
Okay.
And my email is david@svpmg.net.
Very good. Let's switch gears a little bit because another area of your expertise is property management.
Yeah.
You've been doing it for a long time. You've seen it all. You have over 150 properties that you manage under your team. So I guess kind of the first thing I want to start, the first way is talk a little bit about, if you would, someone out there listening to the podcast that either getting ready to rent on their own, or what is it? What are the percentage? You said 70%, roughly, or mom and pop that's still kind of the rental properties.
Yeah.
So a large percentage of people, which, you know, if you have one property maybe and it's next door or whatever, it's fine. But I guess the biggest thing I want you to do, if you can first, David, is explain to the audience a little bit about what it means to be a landlord. You know, some of the primary responsibilities. I think we're in this place, again, where everybody just thinks I'm going to have all these rental properties and I'm going to just rent them. I don't need anybody to help me. And there's a lot of things that could come up.
Yeah, certainly. Yeah, there are certainly a tremendous amount of benefits of being a landlord and being a property owner and owning rental property. There's four different ways you make money renting property, and most people don't know that. They think the only thing they do is make money and rent. But if you if you buy my book or get my book, it kind of explains how there's four different ways you actually make money in rental property.
Right.
But there's a lot of burdens that come along with it too as well. And I find that most properties that I take over from mom and pops or even from other property managers that aren't doing a great job is that they've failed to disclose some of the required disclosures by the state of California, or they are failing to meet the minimum habitability standards that the state of California imposes on landlords. Specifically, Civil Code Section 1941 requires landlords to provide habitable rental units. And consistently, I find that there is some violation one way or the other in just about every property that I take over. And most of it's just because a lot of mom-and-pop landlords are unsophisticated, and that's not necessarily a fault, but it's just they're not professionals, and they don't do it every day. And because of that, they're giving tenants leverage and violating tenants' rights when they don't need to. And it goes both ways, because the tenant has the right to a habitable unit, and they also have a right to make sure that they're living in a safe condition. Landlord has the obligations and the burdens to make sure that, that's happening. And my book just kind of talks about those minimum standards and talks about how a landlord that's considering renting out a property can actually follow along and make sure that they're screening tenants properly, that they're following the law, and that they hopefully won't end up getting those 3 a.m. phone calls or finding themselves in court for violation of the habitability standards.
Yeah. There's so much to renting, and you know, some cities are probably a little more challenging than others.
That's
true. You would know that, right?
San Francisco in particular.
And that gets to the point where in the lower costs or lower income or certain sections, I guess, what would you describe you have to be careful for too, that there's so much around how much you could raise your rent, whether you could raise it or not, how much per year as well, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And those are actually found in the Civil Code on how much a landlord can actually raise the rent per year. And, you know, some properties are under rent control. And so the entire city of San Francisco seems like it's under rent control. But in the city of San Jose, as in other cities, have all adopted rent control ordinances for multifamily buildings to help prevent tenants from being abused. And so there are restrictions on rent increases and restrictions on when tenants can actually be evicted and what those conditions are where a tenant can actually lose their tenancy. And those are all very valid things to have. And I think it's very important for landlords that have properties that are in those types of conditions that they are aware of those laws.
Right.
And I think that's a very important thing.
Right in between our quick break, you were telling me about you're going to be at a function tomorrow night where you're going to be talking about some of these housing issues as far as shortages.
Yeah.
And some of the granny unit laws and things are in place. Where is that going to take place, and what would people need to know about that?
Yeah, it's a community center in San Jose.
Okay.
And people can go to my website.
Okay.
And also my Facebook page, Silicon Valley Property Management Group. And there's a flyer there. We have over 100 people signed up. It's an ADU panel. And what an ADU is an accessory dwelling unit. The state of California just changed the law and made it less restrictive for people to actually and construct ADUs on their parcels, which could be rented out to a family member, a college student, or anybody that is looking for
parents,
a place to live.
Grandparents, whatever, yeah.
And so just to give you some quick numbers, this is an important factor in allowing or hopefully reducing the housing shortage in the Bay Area. In 2016, the city of Los Angeles permitted 80 ADUs.
Okay.
In 2017, they permitted 2,000 ADUs.
Wow.
This year, they're projecting close to 4,500 permits for ADUs.
Boy.
Now, the city of San Jose is experiencing that same kind of demand. I don't have the exact numbers, But you can see how important this is going to be for several reasons. Mm-hmm. One, for an individual property owner that has a fixed income mm-hmm. that's looking for a way to, one, increase the value of their home, mm-hmm. and two, to provide an additional revenue stream for their retirement, this is a great opportunity yeah. as long as they can handle the burden of the privacy issue of allowing someone to live on their property. And these things come in all shapes and sizes. For example, the County of Santa Clara will allow an 800-square-foot ADU on a parcel. The parking restrictions have all but have been eliminated. The lot size restrictions have been reduced significantly. Yeah. So an overwhelming majority of parcels in the County of Santa Clara now qualify for the ability to build an ADU. Now, that is great news for a lot of people, especially people who are looking to get into the rental property right. business, and they previously were financially unable to do so. Mm-hmm. Now it's an option, and now it's something that's on the table. So this panel tomorrow night, I'm going to be moderating this panel. There's going to be an ADU builder. There's a person from the city of San Jose. There's a guy that does financing for it.
Good.
And what it's going to do is it's going to help people understand the ins and outs of ADUs and how that can all benefit both the people looking for property, people interested in increasing the value of the property and generating revenue for themselves.
Right. And that would include also, and only reason because I have this myself, when I purchased a home in Willow Glen in 2005, someone had already changed the garage to a detached unit and did a beautiful job, but they didn't get it permitted. So this would also allow people like that, right?
Absolutely.
Let's say it's already done, but it's not legally permitted, to now go to the city and get that permitted.
Absolutely. The city definitely has a procedure in place where you can actually go and do that.
Very good. We got a couple more minutes. It goes quick. So let's kind of review if we can close out. If you meet this category, if you're renting, currently you have rental properties, and you're not quite sure if you're getting the right service or knowledge or information or feedback from your property manager, you know, give David a call. So first of all, if you're already doing that, maybe you're not happy, you're not pleased, or you're just not quite sure if you're getting the support or the cost structure, whatever it is, it's always good to kind of figure that out. Number two, if you're getting ready to rent, maybe you're not sure, and you've been doing it on your own and you're thinking, I'm too busy, I'm not quite sure I want to take on this liability or issue. You know, there's a couple different reasons I think you should reach out to David. And of course, they could just call and pick your brain and talk a little bit about it. I don't want to speak for you, right? But they could.
That's fine.
They could do that. He's an expert. And, you know, one of the things I love about having people like David on the show, and I always will, is that the first and foremost is giving back and educating people to give them options and let them know that there's a group of people here in every aspect of real estate to help. And that's what we're here to do. Today, David's talking about not only investing, some wise things to do with your money and your equity, but also be smart about when you go to rent a home and you're going to be in a landlord. Be very smart about that and what kind of resource you have. So before we duck out again real quick, David's been kind enough to give away the books. So be sure to go to his website and contact him. We'll give it out one more time before we go if those that want to get the books from you.
David@svpmg.net.
Very good.
My company is called Silicon Valley Property Management Group. I'm on the web, and you go to my blog. I've written over 100 blog articles on real estate development, property management, and I'd love for you to have a copy of my book.
Very good. David, thanks.
Thanks, Joe.
A lot of fun. All right, this is Joe Kuchera with Real Estate Radio Live. Thanks again for tuning in today. Those on Facebook, be sure to download the podcast at RE Radio Live or go to iTunes and do the same. Until next time, take care and have a great afternoon.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Subscribe to our podcast. Discover more at reradiolive.com.